Hello, everyone. This is Sebastian Westerink with the National Weather Service in San Diego, here with this week's weather briefing. Unfortunately, we're seeing yet another strong Santa Ana wind event taking place today into tomorrow morning. This is going to bring a significant threat for fire weather this evening, especially with the very strong winds. We're going to see afterwards a continued weaker offshore wind persisting through midweek and picking up potentially again Wednesday night into Thursday, although not as strong an intensity as what we're going to see tonight into tomorrow morning. And then lastly, we are monitoring the greatest chance that we've seen for widespread wetting, rain, and even potentially mountain snow since early December. Nothing is yet set in stone, but it's the greatest chance that we've seen in our models for a very long time at this point. Looking at the wildfires that are still burning in LA County, we've seen quite an uptick in containment since last week. The Palisades fire is now at 59% containment, and the Eaton fire is at 87% containment. We're hoping that with the onset of offshore winds this week, that they will be able to maintain their containment lines. This is the setup that we usually see, that we've been seeing throughout the winter, that's been giving us these constant pulses of Santa Ana winds. It's a combination between a very high amplitude jet stream, which is bringing very cold Arctic air into the central United States, and on the back end, very cold surface air in the Great Basin, creating a very large temperature gradient, and that is manifested through strong winds that flow from the north-northeast up and over our mountains, where the air is very cold, and then as it descends, it compresses and accelerates, and so that very cold, dry air now turns into milder, dry air and very low relative humidity in combination with the very strong winds, which is how we have our significant fire threats as a result of these weather patterns. This is the look at our upper level pattern for the next few days. Looking at this afternoon's weather pattern, we see that the surface high pressure is very much in sync with the temperature gradients aloft. And so the temperature gradient throughout the column is going to allow for a very strong north-northeast flow into our region, which is why we have the potential for very strong winds and wind gusts today into tomorrow. By tomorrow afternoon, that upper level pattern is going to start to move eastward, and we're going to start to weaken our Santa Ana winds a bit. Our winds will come down for Tuesday night into Wednesday afternoon. And as we can see here, there's another reinforcing shot of cold high pressure air in the Great Basin, where we might see another uptick in winds. So here's what we're looking at. Critical fire weather and very windy conditions through tomorrow. We can see for a lot of our areas, sustained winds 25 to 40 miles an hour with gusts up to 60 miles an hour, and winds locally above 80 miles an hour for the very windiest locations, mountain passes and ridges of the San Diego County mountains, up to 80 miles per hour. And so that, in combination with a very low relative humidity down to 4%, is why we have a red flag warning out for the areas that we have them for. Here's a look at some of your wind gusts in combination with the relative humidity. We're going to see widespread areas that get wind gusts above 35 miles an hour, and some areas that even get see gusts above 50 miles an hour. Areas like in Orange County, Irvine, and Anaheim, as well as some of the foothill regions of San Diego County, like Alpine, could see those gusts temporarily or occasionally above 50 miles per hour. And then, as you can see with the red shadowing of the map here, some of those areas in the mountain passes of San Diego County and some of the ridges can see gusts significantly higher, maybe all the way up to 80 miles per hour. On the right, we have our map of the relative humidity at the same time. And as you can see, the values are very, very critically low. Most areas inland are widespread in the single digits for relative humidity, and some areas even down to 4%. And so that, in combination with those very strong winds, is raising our fire weather concern very high for this event. Here's a look at your afternoon highs for the next 2 days. Tuesday is going to be pretty temperate to average, especially for the coastal plain, where temperatures will remain in the mid to upper 60s, and the mountains will stay very cold as a result of the cold upper level air and the high pressure in the Great Basin region. Now, Wednesday, once that cold air at the surface and aloft starts to move eastward, we're going to be left with very dry air still at the surface. And so the coastal plain temperatures will spike quite a bit into the mid to even upper 70s. As a result of the very dry air, we're going to continue to see very cold morning lows. Some areas, some of the usually colder areas like Oceanside, Temecula, Ramona, could see low temperatures at or below freezing tonight into tomorrow morning. Now, looking at the potential chance for rain and mountain snow this weekend, this is what we're looking at. Model guidance is showing a deep upper level trough coming down straight from Canada into Southern California and deepening as it makes its way down. And model guidance at this point is suggesting that that upper level trough may actually be able to tap into some moisture this time. And so the chance that we see for rain and potentially mountain snow is Saturday into Sunday. And with the system being so cold, we could potentially see snow levels down at or below 4,000 feet. Here's a look at our 6 to 10 day temperature and precipitation outlooks. We're going to continue to see that cold air reach down into the western U.S. finally. And then simultaneously down in Southern California with that upper level trough, we could also see some rainfall, which is why the CPC is giving us a slight chance for above or an above normal chance for above average rainfall. Thanks for watching, and make sure to follow us on social media.